Lesson 4, Creating Accessible Tables. There are 5 steps to creating an accessible table. Step 1, insert the table appropriately. Step 2, enter information into the table. Step 3, identify the column and row headers. Step 4, set the table properties. This includes setting the column header row to repeat at the top of each page, preventing rows from breaking across pages, and adding alt text. And step 5, add a caption if appropriate. In this lesson, we'll walk you through all 5 steps, starting with step 1. Step 1, insert the table appropriately. To insert the table appropriately, select the Insert tab in the ribbon and navigate to the Table section. Choose the Table menu. The keyboard shortcut for this is Alt-N-T. From here, select Insert Table. Never use the Draw Table option because this will result in an inaccessible table. Enter the appropriate number of columns and rows needed. If your table will include column or row headers, be sure to account for this. Step 2, enter information into the table. If the table has column headers, be sure that this information is contained in the first row of the table. In this table, listing Boston rental properties, we'll need both column and row headers. The column headers are property name, address, bedrooms, bathrooms, and monthly rent. Each row has a unique property name as the row header. Our table is now filled in with all our information. If you'd like to include bolded headers, banded rows, or other design elements, now is the time to set those properties. To do this, insert your cursor anywhere in the table. This will enable the table tools to open in the ribbon, which include a table design and layout tab. The keyboard shortcut for these commands are Alt-J-T and Alt-J-L. To choose a table design, navigate to the Table Styles menu. The keyboard shortcut for this is Alt-J-T-S. For this demo, we've selected Word's built-in table style called Plain Table 1. Now let's move on to the next step. Step 3, identify the column and row headers. To identify your column headers, navigate to the Table Design tab. The keyboard shortcut for this is Alt-J-T. In the Table Design tab, navigate to the Table Style Options menu. If your table includes column headers, enable the Header Row option. Column header information should be contained in the first row of the table. If your table includes row headers, enable the first column option. These settings might already be enabled by default. Ensure these options are not enabled if the table does not contain column or row headers. If your table includes column headers, it is important to make sure that the column header row is set to repeat at the top of each page. We'll do that in the next step. Step 4, set the table properties. This includes setting the column header row to repeat at the top of each page, preventing rows from breaking across pages, and adding alt text. The last row on page 1 of our table is broken, meaning it partially spills onto the second page. Page 2 also does not include the header row. This creates confusion for the reader, who has now lost the description of each column and may not understand that the information for Pond View Apartments continues onto a second page. We can prevent these issues in the Table Properties menu. To have the column headers repeat at the top of each page, place your cursor anywhere in the first row that contains the column headers. Right-click or use your Applications key, then select Table Properties. In the Table Properties dialog box, select the Row tab and check the box Repeat as Header Row on top of each page. To fix the broken row, first, highlight the entire table. In the Table Tools menu, select the Layout tab, navigate to the Table section, choose the Select menu group, Then choose the Select Table option. The keyboard shortcut for this is Alt-J-L-K-T. Once the table is highlighted, right-click or use your application's key on the table and select Table Properties. In the Table Properties dialog box, select the Row tab and uncheck Allow Row to Break Across Pages. Now, when we go back to page 2, you can see that the header row is shown at the top. Also, the row for Pond View Apartments has been moved to the top of page 2 to avoid it being broken up into two pages. Next, let's add alt text. When used correctly, alt text can provide assistive technology users with a summary of table contents, including structure and layout. The alt text should first specify the title of the table, then it should include a brief description of the information contained in the table. This helps assistive technology users easily choose which table to navigate to after pulling up a list of all tables in the document. To include alt text, right-click or use your application's key in the table and select Table Properties. In the Table Properties dialog box, select the Alt Text tab. Write the alt text in the description field. It is not necessary to use the title field. In this Boston Rental Properties table, our alt text reads Boston Rental Properties. Column 1 includes property name. Subsequent columns show the address, number of bedrooms, bathrooms, and monthly rent. Step 5. Add a caption if appropriate. Next, consider adding a caption if appropriate in the context of your document. An accurate and concise caption should include the title and can be further used to provide any user with a high-level summary of the content contained within the table. Table captions are particularly helpful for readers with cognitive disabilities. Include a caption by first highlighting the table. Once the table is highlighted, right-click or use your application's key on the table and select Insert Caption. Ensure that the Label option is set to Table and that the Position option is set to Above. The Caption menu will label your table with a number. We recommend you keep this in. If you wish to remove it, you must do that in the document itself. Select OK. Now you have a caption. Make sure your caption is meaningful and unique. Labels like Table 1, Table 2, etc. can easily become confusing. Use a meaningful label that describes the content of the table. In this example, we're using the caption Boston Rental Properties, last updated Fall 2023. Note that the default font size is much too small. Your table caption should be size 12 at minimum. To lock these font settings in for all the captions in your document, select the caption text, right-click Caption in the Styles menu, or use keyboard shortcut Alt-H-L, and select Update Caption to match selection. This will update all current and future captions in your document to these font settings. And there you go. Now you have an accessible table with properly identified column and row headers, column headers that repeat at the top of each page, rows that don't break across pages, alternative text, and a caption. While support for these properties within Word vary between screen readers, these settings will be correctly preserved when you save your document in alternative formats such as PDF, ensuring a more inclusive reading experience for all.